Hi everyone, before we start our discussion, we would like to give you a quick update on our services. Yashoda Hospitals provides the convenience of having online doctor consultations. You can now talk to your doctors across all specialties from the comfort of your home. We also have a free chat option available on our website www.yashodahospitals.com. Let's start our discussion now. On behalf of Yashoda Hospitals, we are happy to connect you with our doctors via Facebook Live. Today's topic is managing cancer patients during COVID-19 pandemic. We have Dr. Nikhil, our consultant oncologist from Yashoda Hospital, Somajiguda. Doctor, thank you so much for being here.
It's my pleasure. Thank you so much.
Doctor, cancer itself a major health concern. With worldwide pandemic of COVID-19, the cancer care is of almost importance now. Let us address some concerns for cancer patients today. Doctor, are cancer patients most susceptible for corona infection?
So as you understand, it's a global pandemic as of now when we talk about the coronavirus infection. Now the cancer patients, as we understand, are at more risk than the other patients, and there are certain reasons for that. So as we understand that even a normal individual has to be very careful in this current situation, that also applies, in fact, applies more to our cancer patients because they are at more risk than the normal population.
Well, doctor, does cancer reduce immunity to infections? Why?
See, cancer itself is a disease which does affect the entire body at times. And because of the cancer, the immunity itself becomes low. Now, there are many reasons for that. One is cancer itself can drop the immunity of a patient. At the same time, there are various treatments like, I would say, chemotherapy or various immunomodulating agents, or for that matter, radiation therapy or any major surgical procedure where the immunity drops. Now, that makes this patient more susceptible for cancer, for coronavirus infections, and that is one of the reasons. Now, that also includes the patients like patients who had also undergone bone marrow transplant, then the patients who especially have certain cancers like blood cancers where the immunity itself is extremely low. So such patients are actually at more risk because of their innate drop in their immunity, and that makes them more susceptible, or I would say more prone to get this coronavirus infection.
Well, doctor, which type and stage of cancer increases the risk for coronavirus?
In general, there are certain cancers which make them more prone for coronavirus infections. Now, just to simplify the situation over here, the patients who have got more of, blood cancer-related diseases like, I would say, leukemias or lymphomas or myelomas. Now, where these are actually the diseases of the bone marrow, and this makes them very much prone for such infections. Also, patients who undergo bone marrow transplant. In fact, there are patients who are actually finished their treatment, like maybe a year or so, where the immunity is almost normal. Having said that, they still potentially stand a chance of getting more infection, more risk of getting infection than the average population. So these are a very typical set of patients who are going to have more risk than the other risk. Regarding the stage, we don't have that much information as of now. But having said that, there is a definite an assumption that the patient who have got more advanced disease, where their immune system or where their organs are under stress, these are the patients who are likely to have get more risk at infection than the otherwise those patients without.
Okay, doctor, are cancer patients successfully recovering from coronavirus, and what to do with those?
As of now, the data is really emerging, so we really don't have a lot of information, even in the science for that matter. But having said that, their recoveries are also being seen. Now, we don't know the exact numbers. We have some numbers from Italy, or we have initial numbers from China, and now emerging numbers from US. But having said that, it's just early numbers because the situation is so dynamic. In fact, we are learning almost every day something new from this particular pandemic. Now, as we understand, the risk of getting severe infections is more with coronavirus. I would say more complications are more likely to happen with cancer patients, and so is the mortality. Just to give some example, if you look at the Italian data, numbers are almost double in terms of mortality as compared to the average population. means I would say around 10% for the average risk when the patient got infection for mortality, here we are talking about 20%. Having said that, 80% of patients are still recovering. So that itself is a big number.
Okay. Doctor, is corona infection aggravating cancer symptoms in patients? What to do?
I did not get your question. Can you come again?
Is corona infection is aggravating the cancer symptoms in patients? What to do?
No, it generally doesn't happen like that. Coronavirus infection is not likely to worsen the cancer symptoms. Mm-hmm. So there is a situation where the patient may not get his treatment because of lack of facilities or lack of availability or variety of reasons. Sometimes patients are not really, they cannot reach the hospital. In such situation, this, the symptoms can worsen, but per se, coronavirus may not increase the chances of symptoms of cancer.
Okay. Doctor, are medications making more prone to COVID-19?
I think I already discussed part of it before. As I said, there are certain patients who are on kind of an aggressive treatment where at times when the treatment cannot wait. Having said that, the treatment really needs to be individualized. But as I said, the treatment itself can sometimes knock the immunity down of the patient, and that makes them more prone. So it's a, I would say it's an indirect impact of the treatment on getting the and on having more susceptibility towards the coronavirus infection.
Okay, doctor, what can cancer patients do if they have symptoms of these infections?
So anytime any patient, in fact, that is something which we are also practicing at our center, that any patient who gets any kind of symptom, we have already been informed that it's important to strike a dialogue immediately with your healthcare physician or a primary doctor. Please inform us, because there are certain times when you may not be able to reach us directly, but at least some kind of teleconsultation, some kind of contact, or at least on the phone, can help us to understand, to assess certain risk, at least for you as a patient. And then immediately it's possible, if it is possible, try to meet the nearby physician, try to get yourself assessed properly and try to mitigate the risk of getting any serious infections.
Okay. Doctor, tell me, if I am a caregiver, how should I distance myself from the cancer patients?
So that itself, when we are talking about the care for the cancer patient, that also applies to the caregivers also. Because as you understand, cancer treatment, it's a teamwork basically. It involves patient himself or herself, doctor, caregiver, and there are the stakeholders in this. So the caregiver, they also have to follow the same guidelines what I think the government has already issued for general population. It means washing hands thoroughly for 20 seconds, use soap and water, sanitizers with alcohol at least 60%, wearing a mask, avoid as much physical contact with the patient as possible. And also, they also have to be equally take care of themselves, because if they are not safe, they really may not be able to take care of the patient. It's a vice versa. It's like it's a two-way situation where patients also have to be safeguarded, and so is the healthcare giver also.
Okay. Doctor, are patients with lung cancer at higher risk for COVID-19?
Probably yes, and I'll tell you the reason. Their lungs are intrinsically, their lungs are a bit weak. Again, this difference seems to be emerging, but there is a very strong observation that the patient with the lung cancer, because of the lot of structural changes because of the cancer, these patients are get more prone for getting COVID-19 infection, and they also need to be taken care of. I mean, they should be very much cautioned about having such kind of infection, and they also deserve that extra care like any other cancer patient.
Okay. Doctor, let me quickly take you across the comments in our Facebook Live. Doctor, one comment is, are patients with lung cancer at higher risk? You answered to this comment already. And will there be any problem accessing my cancer medicines?
Accessing my cancer medicines?
Yeah.
I believe when I'm trying to understand this question, means if I continue to take the medicines, will there be any problem? Or is there something to do with the access of the medicine which they are not able to get? I will answer both parts of it. One is, yes, the treatment, now there is a recommendation, I would say suggestion, and there are various international guidelines which have told us that, including lung cancer patients, that there are certain treatments which can be delayed if they are really not life-saving. If the patient is in actually very advanced stage, and if it is possibility to delay treatments, one can actually delay the treatment. About the other accessibility of the treatment, there are times when there are patients, in fact, which sometimes we are also struggling because of the lack of medicines, because patients are not able to reach the doctor also. It is important to at least be in touch with the doctor all the time, just to understand the situation, so the doctor will at least can tell you, can we wait for a bit longer time, so that eventually once things are slightly under control or we are in a much better condition as a community, we can again go for aggressive cancer management.
Okay. Doctor, Mr. Jeevan asking you, does having received chemotherapy or radiation in the past raise your risk for getting COVID-19?
I think again I have answered this question very briefly. As I said before, the immunity will take a hit when you are when you have received that treatment in the past. The immunity, it might get really hit because of the previous treatments. So it may not be that the immunity almost normal like any other normal patient. So there is a possibility that the risk might be slightly higher. Again, these are only a suggestion. These are only the initial observation. The reason is for everyone, including the best of the societies and healthcare industry, that we are learning from our patients actually. But it is important for those patients who are survivors, who have received radiation or chemotherapy in the past, to safeguard themselves, follow all the protocols what we have been discussing almost on all TV channel, WhatsApp, wherever it is. Yes, so they have to be extra careful. As compared to the normal.
Okay, doctor, I have a question. If anyone would like to have a chemo session.
Hello.
Okay, doctor, I have one more question to ask you. If anyone would like to have a chemo session in a hospital, is it safe for them to visit the hospital?
I like to believe yes. It is because as long as the proper cares are being taken right from the healthcare providers, also by the patient, and if the patients are not carrying any symptoms, and for that matter, the organization or the group of doctors or nurses who are treating the patient. But as I said before, one has to really individualize that patient, whether that patient really need to come immediately to the hospital or can be postponed for a few days. But as of now, we are also doing some chemotherapies at our center, which are very few, which we believe are potentially curing, which can cure our patient. It is probably may not be appropriate for those patients to delay the treatment, because eventually the cancer can come back, because cancer cannot wait. So there are as I am trying to put across this point, we are really individualizing our patient. We are taking our decisions from case to case basis. So some patients are definitely getting treatment. Some patients we are actually delaying treatments. Some patients we are actually changing their IV chemotherapy to some kind of oral chemotherapy, so that some bridging treatment happens in the time patient again comes back to us, and so again we can go back much harder at the disease.
Okay, doctor, is there any cancer helpline number of cancer patients staying alone?
We have all our helpline numbers which are already available. I think most of the numbers should be available on our website. I think you can definitely visit our website. Also, patients who are actually on treatment, all the patients have been provided the numbers of the assistant doctors as well as the nurses, so that in case a situation arises, they at least get some immediate, I would say, telephonic consultation, just to understand their situation, just to understand whether they need to see us immediately or they can wait, or whether they can go and see the nearest doctor so as to get them assessed. So we definitely do a lot of teleconsultation as of now, and that is how we are also trying to help our patients, so as to do maximum in these difficult times for everyone.
Doctor, one more question. After liver transplant for cancer, will I lose liver due to the corona infection?
There is no information as of now like that, and there is no reason to think like that. At the end of the day, coronavirus infection, if at all patient someone gets who had got a liver transplant, these are potentially are at much higher risk, like as I discussed about bone marrow transplant. So these patients are also at extremely high risk of mortality. So it is important to really, I would say, keep these patients properly, almost like shielded from all the sides. So these patients cannot afford to have slightest contact with any person or suspected patient of coronavirus. Remember, if a liver transplant patient getting such infection will be extremely difficult to manage and will expected to have a very high mortality.
Okay. Doctor, one more comment. I'm at stage 2. Will cancer affect me more than corona infection? What should I worry about?
Stage 2 on treatment, off treatment? I'm not able to get that information.
Doctor, this is just a comment from a person. So,
what did he say? Can you come back?
I'm at stage 2. Will cancer affect me more than corona infection? What should I worry about?
As of now, be more worried about the coronavirus than the cancer. And the reason is, yes, stage 2 cancers are very much curable. It doesn't mean that all patients will get a have recurrence. The recurrence chances are much lesser for stage 2 patients. But the exposure to coronavirus patient can potentially put your life in jeopardy. And that is why I think what I believe you should be more worried about COVID than the cancer.
Okay. There's one more comment. The patient who recently underwent surgery, what precautions should they take to protect against this COVID-19?
So patients who had recently undergone surgery and recovering well, I believe I will consider that individual as any other normal individual. So they are not potentially at too much of high risk as compared to a general population. So I would say all the precautions what general population is supposed to take, the same principles also apply to this particular patient who has recently undergone surgery. So like as I mentioned about masking the patient, hand wash, social isolation, and so on and so forth.
Okay. Doctor, one more question. Should I postpone my surgery during this pandemic?
It all depends on what kind of disease we are looking at and what kind of urgency we are looking at for that particular cancer. So there are certain, I would say, semi-emergency or elective kind of surgeries which may wait, which can wait actually, like maybe a small early breast cancer patient where it may not be so early considering that it still can give enough time. But it is at the same time when we are trying to delay the surgery, it is important to be in touch with your doctor, try to understand the situation almost on week-to-week basis. Any changes, any new things, any new findings which are coming up, one can actually inform the doctor. But there are certain cancers which cannot wait. Like some diseases like a cervical cancer, which can potentially from curable to directly become a stage 4 advanced disease, where one can have a risk of losing the patient because of the cancer. So again, as I said before, we really need to individualize the patient. Certain cancers may wait, certain cancers cannot, and that has to be discussed and decided by the doctor and the patient as well as the relatives.
Okay, doctor, before we conclude this live, can you quickly take us to the precautions what cancer patients need to take?
So cancer patients, I think the principles, what I believe everybody knows as of now, I'm sure that most of us have learned a lot through WhatsApp in the recent times. And I'm sure that I believe that the community is also very much aware of it. Now, the principles what applies to our general population also apply to our cancer patients. The isolation, the strict hand wash, the mask, and everything applies to our cancer patients also. As said before, avoid as much as travel as possible. Also try to avoid even travel to hospital if it is really not important. If possible, try to talk to your doctor on phone or through teleconsultation and try to understand the situation if it is really important for them to come to the hospital or we can manage without that. Try to avoid contacts, try to isolate themselves. And I believe these are the special things, I believe, which also apply to our cancer patients to stay safe. This is a very important time for everyone, not only for caregivers, but also for the cancer patients and also for that matter, entire team of oncologists, I would say every stakeholder in this particular situation. And stay safe in such a situation by kind of isolating yourself and avoiding as much as contact as much as possible.
Well, thank you so much, Dr. Nikhil, for being here.
Thank you so much. It was my pleasure. Thank you so much.
Well, that's all we have for now in this live session with Dr. Nikhil. Our topic for discussion for tomorrow is how to protect the elderly population from COVID-19. Till then, stay home, stay safe, keep smiling. Bye.
Thank you.